Hello doctors, in this video we are going to discuss alkylating agent, a group of anti-cancer drugs. First we should know examples for various alkylating agents. We have nitrogen mustard. Example for nitrogen mustard group of alkylating agents are cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide, mechloroethamine, melphalan, chlorambucil, and bendamustine. Another class of alkylating agent is nitrosourias. Example for nitrosourias are carmustine, lomustine, zimustine, and streptozocin. Another group of alkylating agents are causing methylation. Example for this category are procarbazine, dacarbazine, and temozolomide. Another group is called miscellaneous, includes busulfan, thiotepa, and altretamine. All these are example for alkylating agent. First, we are going to discuss general mechanism action of alkylating agent, and then we are going to discuss general properties of alkylating agent, and then we are going to discuss one by one all the group, nitrogen mustard, nitrosourias, like that. One by one we are going to discuss all the group of alkylating agents. First, we see the mechanism action of alkylating agent. Point 1. All the alkylating agent, I put AA, that means alkylating agents. Alkylating agents are binding with N7 guanine residue. That means they binds with the guanine residue at position N7, thereby causing double stranded DNA breakage. They break the DNA strand. They destroy the DNA in various phases of cell cycle. That means you should know alkylating agents are cell cycle non-specific agents. They mainly acting on N7 guanine residue. So first general property, acting on N7 guanine residue. Second important point, they are all cell cycle non-specific. The third point is most important point, that means majority of alkylating agent may cause one important side effect called as veno-occlusive disease of liver, simply called VOD of liver. VOD means veno-occlusive disease of liver. It's simply called hepatic vein thrombosis, also called Bacchari syndrome. So question, veno-occlusive disease of liver is the side effect of which group of anti-cancer drug? Mean think of alkylating agent. Here one important question, to control this thrombosis, we have one anti-thrombotic agent called defibrotide. Very important question, defibrotide, an anti-thrombotic agent useful to control veno-occlusive disease of liver caused by alkylating agent. Another important general property, majority of alkylating agent may cause sterility, infertility. And one more point, most of the alkylating agent may cause secondary cancer. That is, anti-cancer drug itself causing cancer called secondary cancer. Here, among the alkylating agent, secondary cancers are maximally caused by melphalan and also by procarbazine. So melphalan and procarbazine are most leukemogenic, causing secondary cancer. Among the alkylating agent, secondary cancers are less commonly caused by cyclophosphamide. So most commonly caused by melphalan and procarbazine, and very less by cyclophosphamide. In this junction, you should also know what are all the other anti-cancer drug causing secondary cancer. So, secondary cancer can be caused by other group of drug called cisplatin. Here, note, cisplatin and alkylating agent causes secondary cancer only after 4 years of therapy. After 4 years of this therapy, they may cause secondary cancer. Whereas one more group of drug called etoposide. The etoposide may cause secondary cancer within 2 to 3 years, called early secondary cancer. So you should know what are all the anti-cancer drug causing secondary cancer mean. Imagine cisplatin, alkylating agent, and also etoposide. So we discuss in this slide, that is various general properties of alkylating agent. With this general point, now we want to individual group. First group of drug I am going to discuss is nitrogen mustard. We know already example for nitrogen mustard group includes cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide, mechlorethamine, melphalan, clorambucil and bendamustine. Here I go for one by one discussion. First we go for discussion of cyclophosphamide. So very important anti-cancer drug. The first MC question, it's a prodrug. Cyclophosphamide is a prodrug. This drug first undergo metabolism in the liver and produces some metabolite called aldophosphamide and chloroacetaldehyde. The two important metabolites of cyclophosphamide includes aldophosphamide and chloroacetaldehyde. Here, the aldophosphamide further undergo metabolism and produces two more important metabolites called phosphoramide mustard and acrolein. In these two metabolites, acrolein is the dangerous metabolite causing so many side effects. So we should know what are the metabolites of cyclophosphamide. Includes phosphoramide mustard, acrolein and chloroacetaldehyde. Now we move to therapeutic uses of cyclophosphamide. Remember, doctor, cyclophosphamide having anti-cancerous action as well as immunosuppressive action. As the anti-cancer drug, it is useful for treatment of testicular cancer, lung cancer, breast cancer, as well as useful for head and neck cancer. But at the same time, you should know it having immunosuppressive property. Because of having immunosuppressive action, it is useful for some autoimmune disease. For example, cyclophosphamide is the drug of choice for vaginous granulomatosis. So very important question. It's a drug of choice for vaginous granulomatosis. As well as it plays a major role in the treatment of nephrotic syndrome, as well as useful for treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. Remember, doctor, for steroid resistant nephrotic syndrome, the best option is cyclophosphamide. And cyclophosphamide also useful in rheumatoid arthritis. That means it has anti-cancer action plus immunosuppressive action. Now coming to the adverse effects of cyclophosphamide. Now we're going to discuss adverse effects of cyclophosphamide. The most important adverse effect, it causes hemorrhagic cystitis. Very important. Most important problem causing hemorrhagic cystitis. This problem is due to one metabolite called acrolein. Please note down, doctor, which is the metabolite of cyclophosphamide responsible for hemorrhagic cystitis mean? Acrolein. Because of hemorrhagic cystitis, the patient having complaints of hematuria. So to control the hematuria, I want one antidote for cyclophosphamide. That drug going to cause detoxification of acrolein. That drug is mesna. Mesna means mercaptoethane sulfonylic acid. It is the antidote for cyclophosphamide. Can be used intravenously as well as orally. This mesna going to detoxify acrolein, thereby useful to control hemorrhagic cystitis. But if you study Harrison textbook, he says to control the cyclophosphamide induced hematuria, best option mesna. I do agree, but its mesna alone is not sufficient. So to have a better efficacy, along with mesna, we give supplementation of formalin or N-acetylcysteine or carboplast. So question, mesna is the specific antidote for cyclophosphamide. To have a better efficacy, mesna combined with either carboplast. Carboplast is a prostaglandin, PGF2 alpha agonist. Or mesna can be combined with N-acetylcysteine. N-acetylcysteine is a mucolytic agent. It's also a wonderful drug for paraster poisoning. So N-acetylcysteine can be used with mesna to control hematuria. Anyway, doctor, one of the most important adverse effects of cyclophosphamide, hemorrhagic cystitis due to acrolein. But cyclophosphamide also causes so many other problems, like it may cause SIADH. Because of causing SIADH, anti-diuretic hormone action, it causes too much of water retention that may cause dilutional hyponatremia. So another problem, it causes SIADH. And also it causes cardiotoxicity as well as myelosuppression. So here, in summary, the adverse effects, important adverse effects of cyclophosphamides are: number one, hemorrhagic cystitis; number two, SIADH; number three, cardiotoxicity, and also causing myelosuppression. And one more important question, we know cyclophosphamide produces one more metabolite called chloroacetaldehyde. This metabolite causing side effect of nephrotoxicity as well as neurotoxicity. That finishes important metabolites of cyclophosphamide, important therapeutic uses, and important adverse effect of cyclophosphamide. And then we had one drug called IFOS, ifosfamide. It's an analog of cyclophosphamide. This drug also produces two important metabolites, namely acrolein and chloroacetaldehyde. But these metabolites are slowly formed, and the metabolite accumulate in the body for a longer period. So ifosfamide causes more problem than cyclophosphamide, because these metabolites going to accumulate in the body for a longer period. Now we should know, since they cause accumulation of acrolein, it causes hemorrhagic cystitis. For this same antidote, mesna. So remember, mesna is the antidote for both cyclophosphamide as well as for ifosfamide. And one more point, ifosfamide also produces a metabolite called chloroacetaldehyde that we know already causing neurotoxicity and nephrotoxicity. Here one more important question. The neurotoxicity can be minimized by using methylene blue. So methylene blue able to control neurotoxicity produced by chloroacetaldehyde. Anyway, doctor, you should know one point. Comparing to cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide causes more hemorrhagic cystitis and more neurotoxicity, because they are going to accumulate the metabolite for a longer period. Coming to last point, ifosfamide useful for treatment of testicular cancer as well as useful for osteosarcoma. So you should know, cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide are very, very, very important alkylating agent. The next important drug is meclaroethamine. It's also one important alkylating agent. The meclaroethamine useful for treatment of Hodgkin's lymphoma as well as useful for treatment of cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. But the most important MCQ, meclaretheamine, the first MCQ question you should know, it causes skin vesicant problem. Very important, very important. So, alkylating agent, most commonly causing skin vesicant problem, in think of meclaretheamine. So, what we done is, and one more important question, for treating the vesicant caused by meclaretheamine, we can use injection thiosulfate. At the site of lesion, we can inject thiosulfate. So, meclaretheamine induced skin vesicant are treated by injection thiosulfate. In this junction, you should know one more point. Some other anti-cancer drug also causing vesicant. For example, even doxorubicin, vincristine also make a skin vesicant. So, vesicant is the side effect of what are all the anti-cancer drug mean? Imagine meclaretheamine, doxorubicin and vincristine. Now, what we done so far is, in the alkylating agent, we are discussing nitrogen mustard group, where we discuss cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide and meclaretheamine. Now, the next step is melphalan. Very important, very important. Melphalan, alkylating agent, very useful for treatment of multiple myeloma. So remember, melphalan means the most important indication, multiple myeloma. Chlorambucil, alkylating agent, very useful for CLL, chronic lymphoid leukemia. And the bendamustine, useful for treatment of CLL as well as Hodgkin's lymphoma. That finishes one important group of drug called nitrogen mustard. After finishing nitrogen mustard, we move on to another group of alkylating agent called nitrosourea. First, we should know what are all the examples for nitrosourea. The examples are carmustine, lomustine, zimustine and streptozocin. These are examples for nitrosourea group of alkylating agent. In that first MCQ question, carmustine, lomustine, zimustine, these three drugs are highly lipid soluble. Very important, these three drugs are highly lipid soluble, so easily crossing the blood brain barrier, so useful for treatment of brain tumor. So carmustine, lomustine, zimustine, useful for treatment of brain tumor. The next point, the common adverse effect of carmustine, lomustine, zimustine are myelosuppression. Remember, doctor, they cause delayed myelosuppression and sustained myelosuppression. Remember, most of the anti-cancer drug causing myelosuppression within a week, but these drugs are causing delayed myelosuppression and sustained myelosuppression. Next important question, the zimustine causes adverse effect of renal failure. So zimustine we are not using clinically. It is not in use because of causing severe kidney failure. And coming to last one more drug, streptozocin. The streptozocin is called as chemical pancreatectomy agent. So it is useful for treatment of pancreatic islet cell carcinoma. Remember, it is called chemical pancreatectomy agent. That finishes some important MCQs on nitrosourea group of alkylating agent. Now we move on to alkylating agent causing methylation. What are all the examples for alkylating agent causing methylation reaction? Mean think of procarbazine, dacarbazine and temozolomide. Procarbazine, dacarbazine and temozolomide, these are causing methylation reaction. In that first MCQ question, Procarbazin, an important drug useful for treatment of Hodgkin's lymphoma. Useful in Hodgkin's lymphoma. This drug causing adverse effect, most importantly, myelosuppression as well as neurotoxicity. But the two more very important MCQ question, procarbazin causes disulfiram-like reaction in alcoholic patient. That means in an alcoholic patient for treating cancer, if you give procarbazin, this drug may cause disulfiram-like reaction. This is a very important question. Find out which one of the following anti-cancer drug may cause disulfiram-like reaction, mean think of procarbazin. On one more very important question, procarbazin having MAO enzyme inhibitory property, that means monoamino oxidase inhibitory action. Because of inhibiting MAO enzyme, this drug may cause cheese reaction problem. So find out which is the anti-cancer drug having MAO enzyme inhibitory action, mean think of procarbazin, a very important anti-cancer drug belonging to alkylating agent. Then dacarbazin. The dacarbazin useful mainly for Hodgkin's lymphoma as well as useful for malignant melanoma. And finally, temozolomide. Temozolomide highly lipid soluble, so useful for brain tumor. Remember, useful for brain tumor. And temozolomide also useful for malignant melanoma. And the important adverse effect may cause myelosuppression and also causing constipation and fatigue. The main two important problems are constipation and fatigue problem. Next, after finishing so many alkylating agents, now we want to the miscellaneous alkylating agent. Examples are busulfone, thiotepa, alteritamine, and trabectedin. All are miscellaneous alkylating agent. In that, the most important drug is busulfone. You must know. The first MC question, busulfone useful for CML. So very good drug for CML. But again, you should know, even though busulfone very important drug useful for CML, you should know currently for CML, the first line drug of choice is imatinib. A tyrosine kinase inhibitor, imatinib is the first line drug of choice for CML. Anyway, remember, alkylating agent very useful for CML, mean think of busulfone. Coming to adverse effect, busulfone causes pulmonary fibrosis, very important, causing pulmonary fibrosis and also causes adrenal insufficiency. That means Addison disease. We know in Addison disease there will be skin hyperpigmentation, dark color skin. So remember, busulfone causes mostly pulmonary fibrosis and also causing adrenal insufficiency resulting in hyperpigmentation in the skin and also causes cataract problem. Coming to thiotepa, thiotepa useful for breast cancer as well as bladder cancer. Then alteritamine useful for ovarian cancer. An important adverse effect may cause neurotoxicity. And one more drug, trabectedin, it is acting on N2 position of guanine residue. Most of the alkylating acting on N7 position, trabectedin acting on N2 position of guanine residue, useful for ovarian cancer and causing adverse effect of hepatotoxicity. That finishes one very important group of anti-cancer drug, alkylating agent. Read well. Thank you.